This tutorial is a very quick introduction to equivalent equations. We're going to be dealing with standard form versus slope-intercept form of linear equations. And standard form and slope-intercept form both have their uses. Let's say we were given an example, 3 burgers and 2 fries cost a total of $8. Well, which would be better? Standard form, that's ax plus b y equals c, and slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. It would be standard form, 3 burgers plus 2 fries equals $8. It just goes straight into standard form. You just make the b and f into x and y. But we want to make that slope-intercept form, so you got to move the 3x to the other side, and then divide both sides by the 2 to get y all by itself. You also need to switch those around. That minus 3x becomes negative 3x, positive 8 becomes plus 8. And when you divide everything by 2, you're going to get that in slope-intercept form. Y equals negative 3 over 2x plus 4. Now, I'll do another example. It'll be much slower than this. I'll take my time. But that's what's going on. Those are equivalent equations. You have standard form and you have slope-intercept form. Standard was easier to write, but slope-intercept form is easier to graph. You start at the 4 and you're going to go down 3 over 2. Down 3 over 2, down 3 over 2. Nice and easy to graph. But let's go ahead and look at another example. Now, are these two equivalent? That 14x plus 7y equals 21, and the y equals negative 2x plus 3. Well, let's see. Let's do what we did before and try to solve for y. We're first going to move that 14x to the other side like we did before. Let's take it nice and easy. We're going to go minus 14x and minus 14x. So we're left with 7y on the left side, and we have 21 minus 14x on the other side. Remember, they're not like terms. You just leave them like that. And remember, that's a positive 21. I'm going to switch those around in a second. Now we still have 7y. That's going to be negative 14x and a positive 21. Now it's starting to look more like slope-intercept form over there. We divide all of our terms by the 7, so we can get that y by itself. Divide everything by 7. And finally, we get y is equal to a negative 2x plus 3. So, let me see. Are those equivalent? Yes, they are. They're exactly the same. So let's look at another example. Are these two going to be equivalent? 4x plus 6y equals 18, and y equals 2/3 x plus 3. Again, we're going to take that 4x, move it to the other side, because we're going to solve for y. You subtract out the 4x. And notice we have a positive 18 and a negative 4x. We're going to go ahead and skip a step. We write 6y equals, and then just bring down the negative 4x and the positive 18. We're getting quicker at this now. Again, we're going to divide everything by 6. Divide by 6, divide by 6, divide by 6. 6 divided by 6 is 1. Now we need to simplify this fraction. 2 goes into 4 and 6. Divide them both by 2, and we're going to get negative 2 and a positive 3x. And a positive 18 divided by 6 is 3. Are these equivalent? Let's see. We have a negative 2/3 x. Our slope is negative 2/3. Over here, it's a positive 2/3, and it was a trick question. No, these two are not equivalent. So again, this is just a brief introduction to equivalent equations. You try to set them up so that they look exactly the same, and if they're not, of course, they're not going to be equivalent. And again, standard form and slope-intercept form are going to be very common on any test that you see, so make sure you understand how to make them look the same.